lot of discussion about Jose Bautista's bat flip. And as I said at the top of the program, it is out of character for him to, it wasn't even a flip. I mean, it was a flat out sort of Conan the Barbarian toss. We are asking on our poll question today, richeisenshow.com, if you have a problem with it as a listener. How about you as a 19-year veteran of Major League Baseball, Al?
All right, so this is going to be the opposite of what I've always kind of thought, because I've kind of got the old geezer, old fart thing going here with me thinking, you know, play the game right and keep your head down and act like you've hit a home run before. Don't show up the opponent and, you know, don't give any other reason for them to want to kick your, you know what. I have to tell you, Rich, based on how wacky that 53 minutes transpired in that inning and a tie game in a tense moment with Bautista, who is, you know, incredible, you know, with his home run ability, especially the last few years, and his story has been great, you know, how it all started for him and, you know, was a guy who went the other way and was in four or five different franchises that eventually found a home up in Toronto. I think I kind of get it as to why the emotion part. If you watch the replay real slow, you know, he stares down the pitcher a little bit. Then he looks over to the Rangers dugout. Like, maybe that was added. But I I'm not here with that stuff at all when I tell you that, Rich. I do not like that. I was emotional, but it was solely out of just excitement of, like, internalizing it. Like, yeah, you know, one of those. But I think it was fringe. But based on the circumstance, I understand.
Well, I mean, I'm going to reserve the right to, as I said this at the top of the show, is that obviously you're getting caught up in the moment, but I'm going to reserve the right to see if I see a little leaguer do it on ESPN next year. Because when the NFL did away with the touchdown celebrations, and a lot of people thought, again, that's the no fun league doing it again, they did that because high school and some college, some even Pop Warner coaches were writing the NFL saying, my kids are doing this now because you're allowing your professionals to do that. I'm wondering if this fits that description, Al. You are, like, wow. I said, the darn near two-decade veteran on this front.
Wow,
Al. So you tell me.
You know, Rich, I mean, that's a great point, and it is about the kids. And ultimately, you know, I was a little leaguer that ultimately was blessed and lucky enough to have played 19 years in the big leagues. But it starts at that level, and I get that. I think the difference, the variable here would be that you're talking about, you know, full-blown Michael Jackson dance disco routine. In the, you know, the, like, one guy was pulling for his cell phone, whatever that was. Right. You know, like, it was really getting out of hand,
yes.
I think, for your creativity. This, I think, is the danger of you're still going to have guy like Dyson on the mound and others that will take offense to it. And now it becomes dangerous. It's not just for a kid to, like, you know, showboat and think it's cool because he just saw Bautista do it. It potentially could be hurtful based on feelings. That's what it is, man. I mean, you know, Dyson threw a 96-mile-an-hour fastball that he tried to run it away, and it leaks over the middle of the plate, and he gives up the game-winning three-run homer that his team is going home, and now you got a guy in your face throwing the bat. Like, yeah, you know what, you know, there's humans out there. What potentially could be harmful? Because that's the reality of it.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern. On Audience.